can such people be, Captain? Such evil. And she's so beautiful.
Well, the title of my particular episode was That Which Survives, and I played Lucira, commander of the Calandrans, who had died many, many years before.
I am Lucira, commander.
Commander of what?
Of this station.
The computer used my image to to kill, and of course, I being a commander, a soldier, but not the killing kind, didn't enjoy that.
Do not be afraid.
I'm not afraid.
I am for you, Lieutenant D'Amato.
She was called at one point, someone said, or maybe it was TV Guide, said the sad-eyed siren.
I, Lucira, wish you well.
Every time I know when the they graphically took me out of a scene, there was a wail, a very plaintive cry, as I went into a computer blip, I guess it is. I don't know what you would call it. But it was and out. And that, though I didn't do that, somehow they did it, you know, with the magic of television. It gave the feeling of the woman, the sadness of her. But I didn't know that that was part of it until, you know, I saw it on the air. No one had told me that that would be that, you know, that how I would leave each scene.
Oh, what time is it? Now, that has been posed to me before somewhere. I know that she had a crazy clock.
DeForest, the first day that he was on the set, I wasn't working with him, but he came on the set, and my costume was two-piece. It was a top and then a hip hugger pants.
I am for McCoy.
But because of, I guess, the navel can't be shown at that particular time, the cover came up. So, I mean, the top part of the pants came up above the navel, then dropped down and became a hip hugger around the side. So he walked by me, pulled the flap down in front of my navel and said, "What time is it?"
It all seems rather indecent to me.
So I couldn't think of anything funny, wittier to say at the time.
Fascinating.
The next day he came by and he said, "What time is it?" So, okay, he did it twice.
I was constantly asking her what time it was.
And so then here I am, I'm waiting, and finally, the last day, I'm there in my costume, and he walks by and he pulls it down. He said, "What time is it?"
Oh, me? I did that?
He dropped to the floor because I had glued for 3 days this clock face in my navel.
You want to cut that, or I'll be a divorced man tomorrow.
He enjoyed that. So did I, actually. It was fun to be, you know, noticed and paid attention to. And he's a nice man and very fine actor, so it's doubly nice.
My dear girl, I am a doctor. When I peek, it's in the line of duty.
My biggest disappointment was that Leonard worked only one day.
What you're saying is that the planet didn't blow up, and the captain and the others, they're still alive.
Please, Mr. Scott, restrain your leaps of illogic. I have said nothing. I was merely speculating.
I wanted to meet all of them, you know, and but I did. I finally got to work with Leonard, and of course, I did get to work with Bill.
Who have you come for this time?
For you, James T. Kirk. Commander of the Enterprise.
But a goodly portion of mine was separate and apart from anybody else because I was optically put into scenes, and I had scenes with other people that I ended up killing.
I have come for you.
What do you want?
I want to touch you.
But it was before that they could do this optically. I mean, they had to actually film me standing here and then roll the film back, I guess, and then film me standing in this position, roll the film back, and having blocked out those pieces of film, and then again, so that when the film finally ran through, there were three of me walking at different times and talking and saying, I am for you, I am for you, I am for you. But it was so difficult to do, and we did it, oh, a good 5, maybe 6 hours. At least it seemed like that. And it's just really a heavy duty day.